Hey, M90, welcome back. We get to start on our new set of scriptures here today, and we've learned all about the rapture, that event where the Lord is coming back for his church, for those who have been born again, who are ready, and he's calling them up to be with him. So that begs the most important question that we can cover on the topic of the rapture, and that is, how can you be ready for the rapture? Because God's coming back for a people who are ready, who have prepared themselves. So it's vitally important that you and I do what we need to do to be ready for the rapture. It's something that's sudden, it's something that's quick, so we've got to live every moment of every day ready for that wonderful, wonderful hope. So that's what we're covering here for the next six scriptures, helping you to learn through what the Bible says, through the Word, how we can be ready. So let me give you a little snippet of it. First of all, you have to have a born-again experience. Jesus is coming for his church. Well, who is his church? His church is the body of believers that have been born again of water and spirit, as it tells us to do in John chapter 3 and in Acts chapter 2. He's coming for those who are the called out ones, who are living in this world but not of this world. So the best thing you can do to prepare yourself is to seek God, to repent of your sins, to be baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, and that is your initial preparation, being born again, as the scriptures teach us. But that's only the beginning. That's your entrance into preparedness. But then you need to live each and every day with Jesus Christ as the focus of your life, living a separated life, free from sin, living a dedicated life, growing, maturing in the Lord Jesus Christ, making sure that your direction is continually up, is continually being more like Jesus. And when that's the way you're living, living as the church in this world, but not of this world, then you're going to be prepared for heaven. You will be ready to hear that trumpet sound and rise up to meet your Lord in the air. So these next round of scriptures are going to challenge you. They're going to encourage you on how you can make yourself ready that this wonderful event of the rapture doesn't take you by surprise.
Okay, everybody, find a comfy spot because it is story time. I'm going to tell you the story of 10 women. And they were told that the bridegroom is going to come. And they are going to get to go to the wedding. They were so excited. Now, 5 of them were wise women. And so they grabbed their lamps and their oil, and they're all ready to go because they didn't know how long they'd have to wait. But the 5 foolish women just ran out the door because they're so excited. They just ran off and left. They took their lamps, but they took no oil. So they get there and they start to wait. And they're waiting for the bridegroom to come, and they don't know when he's gonna come. And they wait and wait and wait. And it's later and it's later and later. And still no bridegroom. He was delayed in coming. So they gotta wait a little bit longer. And then it got so late that they went to sleep. And then at midnight, the crier comes out and he says, "Everybody get ready, the bridegroom is coming." And so the 5 wise women, they got up and they trimmed their lamps and they poured the oil into their lamps to prepare. And the foolish women, they said, "Give me some of your oil because I don't have enough oil to last any longer. So can you give me some of your oil?" And the wise women said, "Well, no, I can't give you in my oil. I brought just enough for myself. And if I give you any, then I might not be ready for when the bridegroom gets here. So you better go into town and buy some oil for yourself so that you're ready." And so the 5 foolish women, they ran off to town to buy some. And while they were gone, guess what? The bridegroom arrived, and he took the 5 wise women, and he went and took them into the wedding, and the door was shut. So then the 5 foolish women, they came running, and they found the door to be locked, and they beat and they banged on the door. But they came and said, I don't know who you are. You weren't here when I came to get my brides. I'm sorry, you cannot come in." And they were so upset because they missed out on their opportunity to go in because they weren't prepared. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. You see, the story that I just told you is a story that Jesus told in Matthew chapter 25 of 10 women, 5 who were wise and 5 who were foolish. And he was letting us know that we need to be prepared at all times for when he's coming to get his church, because we don't know when it's going to happen. So we have to make sure that we've done what we can to prepare ourselves for when it does, because we don't want to be found looking for something else, searching for something else when he comes for us. So that's why we're talking all about being ready for the rapture, so that you yourself can be ready for him when he comes.